r/AskReddit. People of Reddit, what unethical brands do you refuse to buy from? I don't buy anything from Reddit. The fact someone bought platinum from Reddit and gave it to you is sad. For those of you wondering what this comment said, it was just some generic bait comments to get some poor suckers to give me platinums. Who doesn't love an idiot with money? Ticketmaster. Pearl Jam tried to sue them back in the day. No success. Hey, buy this concert ticket for $50. Processing fee is $3,000 and your firstborn. They even testified before Congress about it. They argued that the artist should have the right to set the prices for their fans who at the time were younger, with less disposable income and were being priced out by greedy ticketbusters. Unfortunately, they lost, and as a result they did a few tours where they avoided playing any ticketbusters venue. That meant in some places they literally had to find a field outside the city to put up a stage, rather than playing the local arena. I refuse to buy from Wish. I don't really have anything against them, but I refuse to buy from them. I don't know why, the cheap scam alert just starts ringing in my brain when I see ads for them. It's a scam with horrible products, but also they steal designs from real people and sell cheap shitty knockoffs with the original creator's images. Yo, OP, in case nobody has mentioned it, there are apps like Buycott and GoodGuide that let you boycott products super easily. For your information, as of the 1st of June, GoodGuide was taken offline. Do you know why? A bunch of companies probably got butthurt. Nestle. Yep, so do I. Lumber liquidators should be on here. They keep getting caught poaching endangered trees for hardwood flooring. Fashion Nova is horrible. Fast fashion is a huge issue. They exploit workers overseas enduring horrible conditions for very little pay, and they also significantly hurt the environment. And steal from small creators, designers. They're a disgusting brand on so many levels. I also hate how all the Instagram influencers promote Fashion Nova. A few sexy ladies influencers I follow are constantly promoting that stuff. Meanwhile, they are always advocating for social issues. Kinda hypocritical. Chiquita Brands International, because it's the continuation of the infamous United Fruit Company. United Fruit Company is the company that engineered a massacre of striking workers in Colombia. Christ man, they coupaid like several Central American countries so they could sell as many bananas as possible. Hence banana republics. I mean, just read up on Dole and why Hawaii is a US state. All MLM and network marketing companies. Walmart. The Humane Society. I'm sure there are more, but I can't think of them at the moment. This is too far down the list. Seriously, MLMs are trash. They treat their employees like garbage. Yes, they are and do. They also sell dangerous products, Bonnet, and give dangerous medical advice, Doterra and Young Living. Then of course some of their CEOs are murderers and doctors who've lost their licenses, among other things. If you read this thread, you will realize that nearly everything you buy comes with serious ethical issues. It is nearly impossible to avoid consuming things that cause harm. What we need more than you individually boycotting a company you just discovered has unethical practices is for you to join a political movement to hold the wealthy and the powerful accountable and to regulate business practices. There are simply too many people who are either oblivious or refuse to be inconvenienced that render little boycotts here and there ultimately ineffective. The market does not regulate itself effectively. This is a myth and a lie. Indeed. The blamers are always focused on the consumer. Don't buy from this company. Buy this slightly more eco-friendly product, when the reality is that the vast majority of environmental damage and CO2 output comes from industry and manufacturing. It's a direct failing of the world government's MO. People always say that we need to pass more laws to protect the environment, but we already have a zillion of those that just go unenforced. If governments would nut up, enforce their own laws, and make the punishment cost more than the profit from the crime, we would probably be on track to be carbon neutral. I'm really trying to stop shopping on Amazon. It's tough. I live in a pretty rural area and I'm not shopping in stores at all lately, but I'm finding substitute vendors for things I can't do without. I've heard some people will find the product on Amazon and buy it directly from the vendor listed. Not sure if that's what you're doing right now, but if not, maybe it's worth looking into. Backcountry.com and its affiliated websites. They hired a bunch of lawyers to sue small businesses using the name Backcountry Anywhere in its name or tagline. Many of the companies were much older than Backcountry.com. They have since sent out a sorry we were caught letter. But there's too many other outdoor companies that are unethically. I can't justify buying from Backcountry. Susan Command Foundation does this to anyone who uses for the cure. They spend more on lawyers fighting this infringement than they do finding a cure for breast cancer. Sinful Colors Nail Polish. 10 plus years back, my sister told me about how they took her friend's nail art pictures and used them for marketing purposes. She asked them to either give her credit or take them down and they refused. I doubt this is the same person, but I recall this happening to someone recently too. Lenovo. It seems every year they are either putting malicious code or conveniently overlooked security backdoors into their hardware. And when called out on it, their response is, "Was that wrong? Should we not have done that?" I have laptop from Lenovo that constantly drops the Wi-Fi. Googling the issue shows it's a common problem. But none of the recommended solutions have worked for me. So annoying. That's a legitimate issue. I thought that was happening because my Wi-Fi sucked. Damn, had no idea. Oh, also Shine. Zaffle. Romw. I am like 99% sure Shine and Romwe are the exact same company, just a different name. The stock is the absolute same, and the websites are super similar as well. I can't remember which way round it was, but Safiya and Nygaard bought clothes from Romwe for a video and one of the pieces came in a Shine bag. Wolf Cola. And their other drink. Fight Milk. It just doesn't sit right with me. If I could ditch the overpriced insulin, I would in a heartbeat, but you know, I'd like to live. Here in Canada, the vial is $40 can. In the US, the same vial by the same company is $550 can. So freaking unethical overpricing life-sustaining medication. In Sweden, insulin is classified as medicine essential for survival. So it's completely free for people with a diagnosis. Anything I see in an ad on YouTube. So Lit Mobile just sent me this solar wireless battery pack. Well, in light of recent events, Jeffree Star Cosmetics. I don't think it's fair to say recent. I've been hearing about it for years now. And I don't even follow Moas. Primark. Kik. The lowest price clothing stores basically. Isn't Kik that dodgy app? Walmart and Amazon. I work for a small transport company, so I've seen how they bully small companies with fines for like everything if you don't do things their way. Plus they also have a lot of internal stories about terrible employee treatment. Whoa, you made it to the end? You're a ducking beast. I'll cut you a deal. Smash like and subscribe for more curated content, bruh. It's free and that's a great price.